While Revit framing elements have clear and predictable modeling behaviors, you may find it beneficial to modify the default behaviors to respond differently to joined elements in certain situations. To illustrate one such situation, we'll change reference planes in a cut-end precast beam to demonstrate cutback and cut-end depth options, and show how they adapt to supporting main beams. Here we see two sets of shape handles for the cut-end beam. One shape handle adjusts the cut-end depth. The other adjusts the cutback. Notice how the parameters allow you to make more precise modifications. At the family level, you can see the three reference planes that define these features. The left plane defines the location line end of the beam at the join. The member left plane defines the physical extent or geometry end of the beam. The third plane, called the C plane, defines the depth of the cut in the beam. To adjust the beam family to better fit into the supporting beam, adjust its reference planes. First, edit the sweep of the beam and align the end of its path to the left plane. Next, align the right side of the void extrusion to lock it to the left member reference plane. Now, when loaded back into the project, the extents of the geometry extend to the join, and the cut end stays flush to the support beam. In this case, the first set of shape handles adjusts the cutback from the end cut edge of the beam, as they're assigned by the member left plane. The second set of shape handles are currently attached to a reference plane that does not drive geometry, but still reports a distance. Now we'll reposition the unassigned reference plane between the left and left member planes and lock it to the location line end of the beam. This allows the C plane to drive the extents of the beam geometry. When the support beam changes, the cut end beams adjust from the left member reference, while the geometry ends remain a fixed distance from the left member plane. In this case, join cutback also modifies the left member plane. With careful planning and skillful use of reference planes and families, you can adjust framing elements to provide flexible modeling options that best suit the needs of your projects.